Welcome to the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition Season 2 Finalist Showcase Premiere.
The trumpet competition designed to enhance trumpeters' abilities, to promote their craft in new and unique ways through video production.
We're excited to present the work of our competitors. We know you will enjoy their submissions. Without further ado, let's welcome the host for Season 2, John Kaplan.
Hey there, trumpet nerds. I'm John Kaplan from John Talks Trumpet, and I'm your host for the Season 2 Trumpeters Multitrack Competition Finalist Showcase Premiere. If you watched or were part of last year's Finalist Showcase Premiere, welcome back. And if you're new, let's get you up to speed. The Trumpeters Multitrack Competition, TMTC for short, is an online trumpet competition where participants show off and compete using their multitracking skills. Multitracking is a creation of a multi-voice recording, performing all of the parts yourself. This competition premiered in 2021, when trumpeters from all over North America recorded, edited, and produced videos to compete for the grand prize. Each piece had to be multi-tracked, which is what you call it when you assemble tracks recorded separately to create a cohesive whole recording. While last year the total runtime and instrumentation was restricted, every other decision was made by the participants themselves. Last year's performances did a fabulous job of showcasing the incredible possibilities of multitracking in terms of creative expression, artistic value, and generating opportunities through exposure. This year, instead of just being limited to North America, the competition was open to any trumpeter of any age worldwide for the solo competition. The instrumentation limitations from last year have also been eliminated, as long as the main feature of each video is still trumpet. Tonight's showcase will feature some new faces, as well as some contestants returning from last season. Each of these submissions were reviewed by a world-class panel of some of the best trumpet players on planet Earth, and 7 finalists were picked by them to be featured in today's finalist showcase. You'll even get to see some highlights of their videos, plus a brief interview with each finalist with Marcus Grant. Out of those 7 finalists, 3 will be chosen as prize winners, and will get to walk away with a cash prize and a voucher for Huber Mutes. But the grand prize winner will also receive a Barkley Microphones Infinity Ribbon Mic, as well as being featured on an upcoming episode of The Trumpet Gurus Hang with Jose Johnson. Now back to David, Brandon, and Marcus.
Thanks, John, and thanks to everyone who is tuning in today. Here at TMTC, we value the time and effort it takes to produce full-blown video and audio productions. Multitracking not only takes specialized expertise as a musician, recording engineer, and video editor, it also demands many hours of development to just create the simplest product, not to mention the astounding videos selected for this competition. We want to dedicate this time to our competitors, who submitted these wonderful videos. Each one deserves high praise and recognition.
If you find someone you enjoy, and we know you will, be sure to check out their individual YouTube channels and subscribe to them and support their original videos. Each video will be available in a playlist in the description bar below, as well as links to each individual YouTube channel.
This year's videos show a wide variety of genres. We were quite pleased with the quality and diversity of the music selected. With all that said, let's go ahead and start the showcase.
Hailing from Rochester, New York, our first contestant is Keaton Viovitny with his own Marvel medley for trumpet ensemble.
From Rochester, New York, and I've been playing the trumpet for 20 years.
What brought you to TMTC?
Interestingly enough, I was like really diving into like home studio stuff and being like, I don't even know what I want to do with this. I was just like buying stuff. And then I saw this competition. I was like, oh my God, this is like the perfect opportunity for me to start exploring what it means to self-produce and make an entire thing from beginning to end. I had never done that.
The video you submitted last season was a phenomenal video. Is there anything that you learned specifically in the realm of producing that you felt you wouldn't have learned otherwise as a musician?
Definitely. Oh yeah. I think there's like kind of the hard skills that were involved, but I think more of the soft skills, planning out that entire journey and comparing the process the second time to the first was actually like mind-blowing. How am I going to go from beginning to end and kind of just making up everything as I went process-wise? I would say that was like the biggest thing that I learned was how to actually produce something beginning to end intentionally. And I think what I ended up with the second time was actually much closer to what I planned.
The idea that you don't necessarily have to know what you're doing in order to hop in and do it, right? You know, it's just like, well, this is what I'm looking for. Let's hop into it and see what happens. We oftentimes as individuals, but I think especially as musicians, are afraid of failure sometimes, and maybe a little too much, because failure is how you grow, right? Being able to put your skills together and to take your skill as a trumpet player and put it in an area where it can most excel and to do it on your own terms. Kudos to you. The video is great. You've made it into finals twice in a row. Is there anything that you'd like the audience to know that we haven't discussed yet?
No, if anything, just like do this competition. If you haven't done it, like seriously get involved. It was a blast. And I think like we talked a lot about just doing it and giving it a shot. I think what you guys are doing is so great with the educational piece of it and having the seminars and like the community around it. You know, the hardest part is not even knowing what you don't know. And there are people who like give it to you and spell it out for you. And like, that's what you guys are doing. I think that's so great. And now feeling a little bit more organized, like I just feel like I would encourage, I'm like telling everybody and their brother about this. I'm like, you gotta do it. Like, it's so great. And it's an opportunity to really, you know, to be vulnerable, but in a safe space where you can put your work out in there and get some actual critical feedback from super experts in the field. And that was something that was invaluable to me, and I'm sure will be invaluable the second time around. So I just had a blast. I think everyone should be doing this, and that's it.
That's awesome. Thank you. There's always someone out there who's thinking, oh, you know, this would be really cool if I could do this. And I would kind of echo Keaton's advice there. If there's something that you want to do, take the leap, but go for it. The worst case scenario is that you learn a really great, valuable life lesson that makes you better the second time around. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you. I look forward to seeing the results as we announce our winners. I'll see you there.
Yeah. Thank you, Marcus.
From Danbury, Connecticut, Jerome Burns performs his exploration of Meshuggah's The Abysmal Eye.
My name is Jerome Burns. I'm currently living in Danbury, Connecticut, and I've been playing trumpet 21 years.
What brought you to the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition?
During the COVID lockdown, I started seeing videos from David, and we would write back and forth to each other. I just love seeing his videos and the way his stuff was progressing, and then I saw you guys started this super cool competition, and I always thought it was really cool. I never thought any of the material I made fit the bill until he reached out to me. All right, I'll give it a shot.
Have you learned or experienced anything that might be unique to being a content creator that you wouldn't have otherwise learned as a musician?
I don't know, because I don't think I would have gotten into any content creation without being a musician. in the first place. It was more of my teacher prodding me. It all started, I transcribed this guitar solo. I was sort of playing around with it and I didn't know what to do with it. I sort of had it in the back of my mind. It might be nice to have like a YouTube video for it. And so then my teacher said, all right, cool. You have 2 weeks. But then it finally, oh, it's out there. And then during the lockdown, I had more time. And so then I just did some more transcriptions and more recording and constantly experimenting, trying to find new things.
Well, it's cool. You've been able to have to build an audience and a presence. You have over 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. Do you have an active presence on social media outside of YouTube?
I tried posting my stuff across Instagram and Reddit. I know majority of my stuff I like sharing through Facebook, and I mainly do stuff inspired by the music of Meshuggah, and so I post it on, there's a really good Meshuggah fan page, and there are all a bunch of cool guys there, and so I post it there every week, and I would say those are the biggest ones, that and Instagram.
Is there anything else in general that you'd like the audience to know at our premiere about your inspiration for the piece and submitting the piece?
I don't know. This one, I was just particularly happy with the way it came out. It's based on a new Meshuggah song that's going to be released on their upcoming album. That'll be released April 1st.
Congrats again on making the finals, and we look forward to seeing the results later on.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm honored that I got to be part of this.
Our goal at TMTC is not only to foster healthy competition through multi-tracking, but also deliver helpful resources on how to build a video production. We want trumpeters to have all the tools that they need to make the content that they desire. That's why we originally built the TMTC seminars, to help break the barriers of entry to recording engineering, video editing, and trumpeting to an extent. Well, we would like to introduce our TMTC seminar membership, a one-time fee to get full access to all TMTC seminars and perks for a given season. This includes free consultations with the TMTC directors about multi-tracking, full access to all TMTC seminars and archived videos from those seminars for that given season, access to content not publicly released, such as tutorials about multi-tracking, a full equipment guide giving you suggestions on what microphones and cameras to buy with full descriptions on all equipment that we use and ones that we know about, and full access to the TMTC Discord. For current students, we do offer an educational discount that reduces the price in half. To learn more about the TMTC seminar membership, go to trumpetmtc.org for more information. We can't wait to assist you in your multi-tracking endeavors.
From the province of Ontario in Canada, Kay Murphy performs their arrangement of The Garden by Brad Meldow.
My name is Kay Murphy. I am from Owen Sound, Ontario, Canada. It's a small town a few hours outside of Toronto. I live in Toronto now, and I've been playing the trumpet for about 14 years.
Very cool. And what brought you to the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition?
I'm just in some trumpet groups on Facebook, and I saw it come up last year. I was stuck at home for the pandemic, not a lot to do. And so I was just doing all these like big covers, a lot of like video game music, like TV music. And I saw this thing come up. So I looked into it. Everything had to be done on only a trumpet. And so I had a couple recordings. A lot of them were done mostly with trumpet, but then with like some electronic instruments, MIDI instruments. But then when it came up again this year, I was already following the page and they said that you could do any instrument as long as it featured the trumpet. So I'm glad that the rules kind of opened up for that this time around, and I was happy to apply for it.
Do you have advice potentially for any individual who maybe feels intimidated by the process of putting together a multi-track?
I didn't do too much recording before the pandemic started. I had a lot of fun experimenting with it for about 3 weeks. But then, yeah, then I started to get intimidated by it and I got quite burnt out after like feeling like I had to be doing all of this stuff. I felt like I had to be just like making things all the time because I had nothing else going on. When I decided to come back to it, I had already kind of like, I was already a little bit familiar. There's really no rush, I guess, would be my advice. There's no rush. You can always come back to it. And any amount of time that you put into it will stick with you and you'll have those skills. I was slowly building.
I like to tell people every staircase is climbed the same way, one step at a time, right? Can you tell us how many instruments total were in this recording? There's a lot, right? You have a brass yeah. band instrumentation, which we're going to talk about in a minute.
Primarily the trumpet. And then there's a little bit of trombone and alto sax. There's a sousaphone and the drums. And then there's some MIDI instruments. I have like a synth bass and a synth like lead line going on somewhere in the middle. So like five and then technically maybe six. I mean, I also sang, so I guess that's a seventh instrument. But off the top of my head, I want to say there were probably around 60 to 70 track.
Is there anything else that you'd like to tell, to share with our audience at, that we haven't spoken about?
I guess, yeah, I might as well say why I decided to choose this song. I remember when Brad released this as a single before that album that came out in, I want to say 2019, his album Finding Gabriel. This was the first track that came out, and the first time I heard it, I was like absolutely mesmerized. At the time, I was playing in one of the large ensembles at University of Toronto, and I decided that I wanted to arrange it for us to play, and we played it. And ever since then, every time I find myself in a large ensemble, I always want to like bring that arrangement in.
We have you to thank for a really great submission. So thanks for sharing your time and your talent and your passion.
Keeping that Canadian connection going, from Montreal, Quebec, Cameron Milligan performs his spicy 7/4 take on All the Things You Are.
My name's Cameron Milligan. I live in Montreal, Canada. I've been playing the trumpet for around 15 years now.
Would you mind telling us a little bit about what brought you to the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition?
It was really a combination of luck and coincidence. During the month of January, I put the arrangement together and started working on the video. And I had finished it at the beginning of February. And David Koch, who also used to study in Montreal, who I kind of knew by reputation but didn't know personally, you know, heard about my video through a mutual friend of ours, and you know, it just so happened that the competition was closing that week, and he reached out and said, you know, you might be interested in this. So very lucky that I had decided at that point to learn video editing and to put it together, and that these series of connections and coincidences got him to see the video and to mention the competition to me.
The trumpet world is really small.
Yeah, small, and I find, for the most part, very mutually supportive. You know, I haven't met anyone with any reasonable success who doesn't also want to share knowledge and see other trumpet playing peers improve. So it is a very good community, and I've been fortunate to receive and give support.
Is the arrangement that you put together on sale?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, I have it totally prepared and formatted, so if anyone is interested in that, then I invite them to contact me.
What would be the best way to contact you if someone was interested?
The best way would be through email, CameronMilligan@gmail.com.
Perfect.
Yeah, I'm really happy that I'm able to do it. You know, it came about at a time where playing with other people was not very possible. Writing an arrangement this way and using virtual instruments in addition, you know, with the rhythm section sometimes allows you to maybe realize things that would be very difficult to control with a live band. It's really a great skill to be able to do that just on your own, because we end up in these situations where you know, we don't always have the resources around us, and we have to find creative ways of still bringing our own voice out. So I feel that just through making this video, it's really widened my skill set, and I can come up with an idea and have a product that I can show people within my own like home office. It's very empowering. It's another great aspect of this competition that I think you're encouraging the right ideas, because it's very empowering for people to have these skills and to not need to hire other people or to not be limited. We are ourselves are capable of producing our own products and showing that to the entire world.
I think that's a really powerful message for anyone, you know, kind of looking to market themselves as musicians in any sort. You took a very tasteful approach to including a variety of mutes. And one of the things that's a great advantage to trumpet ensemble is that wide variety of mutes that we have. So would you mind walking us through your thought process as to how and why you chose certain mutes for certain lines?
Initially, the first recording I did, like, I wasn't thinking of mutes, but it was kind of late and I'm in an apartment. So I recorded the whole thing on Harmon mute just out of sort of practicality. And then I thought, well, actually a lot of the, you know, the head, the first head sounds really nice in Harmon when the arrangement is quite tight, block voicings, dense voicings, the counterpoint line in cup mute gave it again like a bit of contrast on the bridge section. The trumpets playing the backgrounds and the melody are open, and just that little bit of detail I think that gives you this sense that this is two different voices. The muted solo with a synthesizer actually at a certain point, and then having the soli, it just gives you the contrast and ebb and flow you need in order to have an arrangement work. If it were a big band arrangement or an arrangement for different instruments, probably you would have, you know, saxophones doing the response line and trumpets doing, like, it would be more sectional sort of arranging. But because we're limited in that we only play one instrument, the mutes allow for that same sort of difference in timbre that you would get having those different sections.
Congratulations on making finals, and I wish you best of luck in those results.
Thank you so much, Marcus.
Mike at Barkley Microphones. Join me here in my remote horn recording studio. This is where I also built my microphones. I just wanted to share a little word with the entrants to the TMTC competition. So I have been sponsoring this from the start. It's a competition that's kind of close to my heart, being a trumpet player. And an opportunity like this would have been greatly received if I was younger and in the position to compete online like this. And I was thinking what would benefit me as that musician. And in the world that we live right now, having the skill of online content creation, working remotely and so on, is paramount to a successful music career. One of the things that can really help you there is having high quality audio. So being in the position that I was when I was younger, I started building microphones for myself to be able to afford something with enough quality to do the work that I wanted to, and that's how I learned how to build these. So I built them for myself and then realized these are a good microphone. People seem to really like these and started asking me to build them for them. That's where the company came from, and that's where the product came from, was my necessity as a trumpet player to record myself well. So I just thought, this is a great competition, this is a great possibility, an opportunity for me to support an upcoming musician in their career. So I wanted to offer the winning applicant an Infinity Ribbon microphone. Thanks again for being part of this. I've been Michael Barkley, Barkley Microphones. Have a nice day.
From Long Beach, California, Tati Geisler performs Rob Freer's arrangement of Variations on America by Charles Ives.
I'm from Long Beach, California, and I've been playing trumpet for about 16 years.
What brought you to the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition?
I remember seeing a couple of submissions on my Instagram page and my Facebook page, and I was really intrigued. I don't believe I found out about the competition until after everything was due, but I was really excited to take a look at it and see what people had submitted, and I was really, really impressed by just all the variety and just all the creativity that everyone had come up with.
Have you had experience previously with the art of multitrack?
I did a couple of multitrack videos previous to this during the pandemic with some fellow trumpet players. I really wanted to work on this skill and kind of challenge myself. And so when I saw that applications were open again this year, I was really excited to try it out this time.
You made a choice of music that I personally think is super awesome. A lot of people wouldn't think to play Ives anywhere just because it's really hard to pull it off, and you took it into a competition. Can you tell us a little bit about what inspired you to choose specifically that piece?
Sure. As I mentioned, I took a look at some of the previous videos from the finalists last year and listened to all different types of music, and so I was trying to think of what piece might be good, what kind of might stand out, or just a piece that I'd really enjoyed. One of my trumpet professors from Cal State Long Beach did an arrangement of the Ives for a Long Beach trumpet ensemble some years ago, and they actually went on to perform the piece at the National Trumpet Competition. I loved the way they performed it and just all the versatility of all the different types of trumpets, and I had always wanted to try to perform that or try a couple parts of that, and so I thought this would be a really cool piece to use for the competition.
Very cool. And so in deciding to want to play a couple parts for them, you then played all of the parts for them. For our audience members who maybe aren't trumpet players, but they're watching this event, how many parts total was in the arrangement? And then how many different trumpets did you play?
So there were 8 total different parts. And of that, there were 3 flugelhorn parts, 3 sea trumpet parts, and then a piccolo part and a B-flat trumpet.
Which obviously adds for a variety of timbre, of tessitura, higher and lower notes, and as well as you get the smoothness of the flugelhorn, and then you get the brightness of the piccolo trumpet, which is surprisingly difficult for a balance and blending standpoint. You made that work really effectively. Do you have any advice for some people who might want to get into the world of multitracking but are maybe a little intimidated as to how to get started?
Doing it with a friend, I think, definitely helps. Or just kind of taking a look at what other people had done so far, what so many other trumpet players on Facebook, on YouTube, on Instagram, what they come up with. I love just spending time and seeing what kind of pieces they're doing. A lot of times, so many of them are so helpful, and they'll actually say which programs they're using or which mics. So I try to kind of take note of that, or just take another look at that. And I would say just kind of going for it. I felt very hesitant trying out for this year, but I kind of wanted to just dive right in and see what happened. And I'm really excited that I did, and so happy to be here.
Congrats on making the finals, and I wish you the best of luck as we announce our results.
Great, thank you so much.
From Savannah, Georgia, Matt Brockman performs Seb Skelly's arrangement of Hideaway by Jacob Collier.
Testing, testing, testing. All right, go ahead. You good to go? All right, cool.
Start off telling us your name, where you're from, and how long you've been playing trumpet.
Matt Brockman. I currently live in Savannah, Georgia, but I'm from New Jersey. I've been playing trumpet for 15 years.
Nice. So what brought you to the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition?
I've been doing multitracking for over 2 years now. I was just inspired by what Christopher Bill was doing, Seb Skelly with his brass quintet stuff. When you have a job, you don't really get to pick what you play anymore. And it was just a creative outlet for me. Then about like a year later, I think this competition was born. And I was like, okay, well, I do this, so why not?
Very cool.
I entered.
Yeah. What are some valuable lessons you learned as a content creator?
Social media is really, really powerful. And I didn't realize that before doing this, and it really pushed me to develop different skills. I mean, with the multi-tracking, the audio editing, the recording itself is a skill on its own. Video editing, I've gotten a lot into marketing and business lately. Kind of just opened up an entire new career for me, honestly. From the outside, it looks like people are making like silly videos or whatever, but it can really lead to something else if you give it an honest go.
So Matt, as a returning champion to this competition, can you tell us a little bit about the inspiration about your choice of music and the creation of the video?
Yeah, absolutely. The most effective kind of music video is one that has some sort of emotional connection with the audience. With Hideaway, with Jacob Collier, I interpret the song as someone who, it's just like a nostalgia kind of thing. It's like going back home to where you're safe. I kind of based it on my own life a little bit. The first part of the video was shot in downtown Savannah early in the morning, 6 a.m. when no one was out. I wanted to portray this kind of homesickness in the video. And then in the video, I traveled back home and I actually went back to New Jersey to my parents' house to film the second part of the video. And going through like old family photos and old family videos and kind of like reliving the first half of my life.
The storytelling element is definitely easy to see, and it's really cool to see you put together a video from a producer's standpoint. Is there anything else that you want to add or just let the audience know?
My advice to, I guess trumpet players of all ages, but especially young trumpet players, don't be afraid to be different. Don't be afraid to stand out, and don't be afraid to do your own thing. Because I know a lot of trumpet players, they set these standards for themselves where like, you gotta play Mahler 5, you gotta play the Haydn Concerto. You're not a real trumpet player if you play anything else. And I moved away from that mindset, and I'm glad I did. So don't be afraid to be different.
Congrats again on making it to the finals, and best of luck as we reveal the results later on.
Thank you.
We're excited to announce a partnership that we've formed with Diversify the Stand. In the very near future, TMTC and DTS will be doing a call for scores for Trumpet Ensemble Works. The winning submissions will receive a multi-track recording from Marcus, Brandon, or myself. We will have the full details on our website very soon, so be on the lookout for that. We hope that you'll participate in this call for scores.
From Long Beach, California, Jessica Farmer performs her own arrangement of Ocean Eyes by Billie Eilish.
is Jessica Farmer. I am from Long Beach, California, and I've been playing trumpet 14 years, maybe?
Yeah.
Second year masters.
You placed yourself in the finals last year with a very polished arrangement of Star Trek, and it seems like you had quite the glow up this season. Would you be willing to share a little bit about what you learned?
Last season was my first ever arrangement for a trumpet ensemble. I actually just recorded that one in my room with just like a camera tripod and like kneeling down on my bed because the background was the only blank background that I had access to. So it was kind of uncomfortable, but that was how I did it. But this year I wanted to do more of a music video style at sunset. It was kind of spur of the moment, all the ideas that I had, they were just coming to my mind as we were filming. It actually worked out pretty well. Plenty of outtakes for sure of sand and water and all of that.
It's really cool and really quite fascinating. Even cooler than that is just the incredible smooth and seamless nature of the audio mixing that you have. It's really difficult in many ways to tell whether or not what you're listening to is trumpet or whether or not what you're listening to is MIDI.
Most of it is trumpet.
How many tracks would you say that you recorded, including your double length?
The background trumpet has 12. The verse trumpet is just one. And then for the chorus, I've got 5 different trumpets. For the second chorus, I've got 6. And then the bridge, there's 2 plus the reverse trumpet.
So you have close to 30 different trumpet tracks.
It was really fun and very rewarding. And the harmonies that she does are just so beautiful. And it sounds surprisingly good on trumpet.
Yeah.
You know, I don't want it to sound like trumpet. And I think I succeeded in that area of it not sounding like a trumpet player playing a pop song. I've learned so much, I think, from the arranging process. I've learned how to record myself. I think it has helped my ear a lot. So, you know, of course, performing in ensembles has actually kind of been a little bit easier. And I've also learned kind of how to market myself, and coming out of my shell with this content creation has just been an integral part of, I guess, just becoming me.
Do you have any advice for any individuals who might be looking to do the type of thing that you're doing right now?
If you think it will sound good on trumpet, try it. And even if it doesn't sound good, it doesn't matter. The most important thing is to just have fun with what you're doing. You don't need the most expensive equipment. All you need is to just have a passion. It's going to impact someone's life. I just firmly believe that anybody who has a passion for something can succeed.
Congratulations again on making it into finals. I look forward to the announcement of our results.
Yes, me too.
Let's take a moment once again to congratulate everyone for their outstanding work. It's been great to see what everyone came up with, and it's certainly given me inspiration to try some new things in my own videos. Speaking of inspirational, how about those interviews with Marcus? Wasn't it great to get to know each of the creators a little bit? Personally, I find I'm much more invested in each video when I know the person behind it. Thank you so much to everyone for your additional time, and to Marcus for heading up those interviews.
A common theme among competitors this evening was that they only recently started multitracking, but when they did, they noted multiple benefits to their overall career. If you're interested in starting multitracking but aren't sure where to start, send us an email at trumpetmtc@gmail.com. Our chief goal is to teach, promote, and showcase the art of multitracking across the trumpet community, and we would love to speak with you.
Now, let's get on to the part that everybody's been waiting for. John?
Now we're at the most exciting part of the event, when we get to announce the winners. Every single one of these submissions were fantastic and are deserving of their own congratulations, no matter how the results shake out. Creating even just an audio multitrack is no small feat, and each of these also has a video element. In creating these, all of these musicians are honing the technological and musical skills that are basically required as our world transitions into a more digital age. Without any more delay, let's get on to the winners. earning $500 plus a $100 voucher to be redeemed at Huber Mutes. The third place winner is Jessica Farmer and her arrangement of Ocean Eyes. In second place, winning $1,000 cash and a $175 voucher to Huber Mutes is Matt Brockman's performance of Jacob Collier's Hideaway. And now for our first place winner, who will receive $2,000, a $250 Huber Mute voucher, be featured as a guest on an upcoming episode of the Trumpet Gurus Hang with Jose Johnson, and receive a Barkley Microphones Gen 2 Infinity microphone. Congratulations goes to Cameron Milligan and his version of All the Things You Are. Once again, a huge congratulations to Cameron, Matt, Jessica, and to all of our finalists and competitors. As I said before, it's quite a task to create a multitrack, but then to subject it to judging brings the intensity to a whole new level. And of course, without all of you, this competition wouldn't exist. I'm John Kaplan, and it's been amazing to host you today. Time to hand it back to Brandon, David, and Marcus.
Thanks again, John, for hosting today's event, and congratulations to the Season 2 winners of the Trumpeters Multitrack Competition. Also, thank you to our sponsors for Season 2. These include Barkley Microphones, Huber Mutes, and the Trumpet Gurus Hang. We cannot do this event without you.
I'm sure the question on everybody's mind is, will TMTC be back for Season 3? And the answer is yes. We plan on taking a small breather to shift our competition schedule so that it falls in the summer months instead of one of the busiest times of the year. Start preparing now for TMTC Season 3, happening summer 2023.
Be sure to follow us on our social media platforms to stay updated with all the exciting events happening between Season 2 and Season 3. Our next season will be here before you know it, so be sure to get started on those stellar videos today.
I'd like to make you aware of our TMTC Season membership. In December 2021, we had a seminar weekend where Brandon, Marcus, and I gave courses about how to advance your multitracks, with two additional sessions by Michael Barkley of Barkley Microphones and Military Trumpet Jobs. If you subscribe to our season membership, you'll gain access to the videos from that seminar weekend, member-exclusive areas of our Discord server, private feedback from the TMTC directors, and any future member content. Please visit our website for more information on becoming a member of TMTC. Thank you to John Kaplan for hosting us today. Go check him out on social media at John Talks Trumpet. Thank you once again to all of our competitors. And for those of you joining us in our audience, thank you. We'll be seeing you. The other.